I'm Reverend Sam, and I'm your host on The Secret of Glory and Power. Do you know that you are brought to this world for a purpose? Do you know that many people will suffer if you do not accomplish the divine purpose that God has ordained you to bring to pass in this world? Do you know that some people's success are directly connected to your success, and your failure will be the barrier of their destiny? Do you know that men and women can actually be encouraged to move forward in life because of you? And that's why we have this program, The Secret of Glory and Power, so that you can be encouraged, because all of us, at one time or the other in our lives, we feel discouraged. Anyone who has never felt discouraged, I've never done anything great. At a time, Elijah said, you know what? Let me die. I'm no better than my forefathers. Because he was face to face with some challenges that are beyond his reach. But I believe that God will use this program to touch your life. Because we talk about stories of men. There's a saying that the secret of men are their stories. We talk about the stories of men. And why do we talk about those things? So that we can help you and many other people to know that it is human to fail, and that you can choose to start all over again. So this program is that which helps you to pick lessons from the stories of men. I have my story, you have your story. Anyone that doesn't have a story has never done anything great, because in life, we've got to fail and succeed. Now, and when you bring your advert to this program, you are doing two things. Number one, you are helping yourself, because you are helping this program to stay on here, and the anointing of God on my life will be working for you because you are helping my vision. Though you bring your own advert, we air it, and the viewership of this program is becoming larger now. They are going to watch this program. They are going to see your show. They will patronize you because you are helping us. But apart from that, we have progress, because I know our God is a God of progress. So, call the number on the screen, bring your advert to this program, and you will experience God. Wow. I started the story of Jonah last week, and I just want to continue. Jonah is a man that decided to rebel against God. God tell him, Jonah, I want you to go to Nineveh. The people of Nineveh have done what is bad. I don't want to destroy them. Go to them and tell them that if they don't change from their ways, I'll destroy them. And you know what? Jonah packed his bag. Jonah packed everything and decided in his mind that he was going to disobey God. He went to Tarshish instead of going to Nineveh. And you know what happened to him? What happened was that while he was going, when he was in the ship, all of a sudden, against all navigational expectations, wind started blowing against the ship, and water started pouring into the ship. That the owner of the ship and everyone said, no, this is not normal. The forecast we had does not show that there's going to be any wind, and they know it was not ordinary. What they did was that everybody now started calling upon their own God, and the owner of the ship brought out his oracle, and they started casting lots. Don't know who in the ship was causing the wave to come. Because you see, that man is experienced. He knew that somebody must be in that ship who was not supposed to be there. He knew that wind must be the hand of God that is working against the ship and everybody in the ship because of one man. My question is, are you that one man? That the ship, the wind is blowing against everybody because of you? Finally, they got to know it was Jonah. And when they got to know it was Jonah, Jonah said to them, I know I am the reason why this thing is happening. Because God sent me to go to Nineveh, and I chose to go to Tarshish. I don't know why he did that, but it's not a good reputation. I don't think he trusted God. Because if you trust God, you will obey his voice. If you trust God, you will do what he says. Because you know that at the end of the day, whatever God asks you to do must be for your own good also. So he said to them, you know what? Throw me into the sea. Once you throw me into the sea, the wind will cease. And they pick him up, throw him into the sea, and you know what happened? The wind just went down. My question to you is, are you in that situation? Are you in the sea right now? Have you been thrown out because people discover you are the one that always caused bad luck to come? You are the one that always opened door for evil to take place? Listen. You can change today. You can say to yourself, I don't want to run again. Listen, God is the one that created the heaven and the earth. The hand of God can reach anywhere, four corners of the earth. Where can you run to that God will not meet you there? Maybe you run to America because you don't want to do what God said. Really? You can't run away from God. When God is still watching you, it's because your time of judgment has not come. When the time comes for judgment, the wind will blow. But you can make a choice today to say, you know what? I don't want the wind of God to blow against me. I don't want the wind of God to blow against my family. Because Jonah costed people their money. People started throwing their goods, the good they took from their hometown, they attended to Tarshish. They began to throw the goods into the sea just to lighten the ship, not to sink. They lost a lot of money because of Jonah. But when they throw Jonah out, the wind ceased. But that's not the end, because our God is a God of another chance. I don't know what you've gone through in life. I don't know what you have done, but God has a second chance for you. When you look at verse 17 of chapter 1, the Bible tells us that, and the Lord appointed a great fish to swallow up Jonah. When they throw him inside the water, he will have drowned and just die. But God does not want him to die. So God had to send a great fish to go and swallow Jonah. That was miraculous. And that is a sign of redemption. Maybe you are watching me right now, you have been going your own way. You have been doing your own thing. You have been going against the written law of God. You have been going against the thing that God wants you to do or want to carry out. Maybe God wants to set up an NGO. You are so consumed with the greed for money that you said, no, I'm not going to do it. I'm going to make money now. And you have done everything you can. Nothing's happening. God can give you another chance. Just like God allowed the whale to swallow up Jonah, God is telling me that to tell you that somebody is watching me, this is your time for redemption. God is ready to give you another chance. I beg you, don't blow it. Because if you do, there may not be another chance again. And listen, don't you think that it is better to obey God? This is the way I think. Every time you wake up and then you sleep at night, the number of your years reduces per day. Whether you like it or not, you are growing older. What will it look like when you get to heaven and discover that you did not even fulfill the plan of God for your life at all? Wow. I think the best thing we're supposed to do as people is to obey God. So if you are disobeying God, please obey God. Even if he doesn't have, if money is not involved today, God will ultimately bless your obedience. He may bless your obedience by giving you money, or he may bless your obedience by giving you a lot of favor. And you know, favor, there's a problem in language that you are going to look for favor. You are going to look for money. You meet favor on the road. What you need is favor to get money. What Esther got was favor, and then he became the queen. What Mordecai got was favor, and that's it. When God gives you favor, that's all you need. Wow. That whale took up Jonah. And Jonah was in the belly of the fish 3 days and three nights. That is symbolic of Jesus Christ dying, being under the ground for 3 days and three nights. It's a sign of salvation. It's a sign that God wants to redeem you. You have been running away from God. Maybe God wants to use you. And you have been saying, no, there's no money in this pastoral work. I cannot work for free. You know, I cannot work for free, or I can't work for free. They cannot pay me, I can't do it. Listen, obey God. Don't be like Jonah, because at the end of the day, you will suffer loss. And in chapter 2, Jonah began to pray in the belly of the fish. He began to pray, and he began to pray, and he began to pray, and he began to repent. And he began to repent, and he began to repent. And I think you that is watching me, there is also time for you to turn back from your wicked ways. Turn back from the way that you know is not pleasing to God. It's time for you to turn back and follow the way of God. Listen, the way of God encompasses lasting peace. You cannot enjoy life without God. You can't. You cannot enjoy the goodness of God except you're obedient to God. And I want you to yield yourself to Him. If he asks you to marry somebody, as long as the person fears God and the person has a vision, marry the person. Marry the person. If he asks you to start a particular thing, start it. Somebody's destiny is connected to it. I was talking in the last episode. You know, I was talking about the fact that at a particular time, God asked me to start a fellowship somewhere. And the fellowship was not growing the way I expected. But a few people were coming, new people were coming. And then a particular time came, I needed a document. It was an official document from the government. And there's no way I could get this. I was looking for how to get this document. I could not find a way out. And then after fellowship one day, we were just talking, you know, just talking with those who came. And I said, I'm trusting God for this and this and this and this. And one sister said, Reverend, don't worry. I will see what I can do to help. You know what? God used this sister that was invited by another member of the fellowship. This sister was the one that God used to get me that document. So if I had not obeyed, it's possible I would not get that document. Because it was the fellowship that I started, that sister was invited to. It was when she began to fall in love with my anointing. And then she knew what I needed. And then she was in a position to help out, and she helped out. I'm just saying that to let you know, it is better for you to obey God than to disobey him. Many of us, we are the one that is delaying the day of our redemption, the day of our glory. You keep saying that you have great dream, great vision, but things are not coming to pass the way you envisage them, the way you see them. Many a time it is because you have not taken the step that God wants you to take. Because God will always bless obedience. No matter how far you have run, you will start all over from the beginning. In chapter 3, verse 1 to verse 3, after Jonah has repented and the whale now vomit him at the seashore, the word of God came back to him and said, Jonah, you know we have an unfinished business. I want you to go to Nineveh. I want to go and warn those people that if they don't repent, I'm going to destroy them. This time around, of course, he had to go because he had seen the other side of God's hand. Listen, don't wait until you lose everything before you obey God. Don't lose your husband. Don't lose your wife. Don't lose your children. Don't lose your rest of the mind. Don't lose your business before you obey God. Why must you suffer loss before you obey God? Some of you, you marry who you are not supposed to marry, and then the marriage is not working. And then you are now out of the marriage, and then you are divorced, and you are unsettled, you know, and your life is now a ridicule. But it will have been averted if you had married the right person. You are supposed to do a particular thing. Maybe you're supposed to have a particular program that can help people. Because I believe that God always wants us to help people. But you choose not to do it. Maybe somebody come across your way who is in need, and God keep telling you, I want you to help this person. I want you to do this and so for this person. But you are saying, no, what has he done for me? What benefit have I gained from her? I'm not going to do it. You are like Jonah. God said, go to Nineveh. You say, I'm going to go to Tarshish. You've got to repent, because if you don't, God will still save the people that he wants to save. If you don't, God will still raise somebody else to help that person. But you will lose your own reward, apart from the sufferings that they're going to encounter. Jonah finally went to Nineveh because he had no other choice. I think it's time. I believe that this program is actually is God calling you again, telling you, I've not forgotten what I told you to do for me. I've not forgotten what I asked you to do. Will you now do it? Or do you want me to judge you like I judged Jonah? Don't let God judge you. It's not palatable. It's not. It's not palatable at all. When you look at chapter 3, when you look at verses to 10, we are told that when Jonah went to Nineveh and he began to ring the bell and began to proclaim the messages, we are told that everybody's heart was pricked. Everybody became touched, to the extent that the news got to the king in the palace that there's a prophet that has come from from wherever he came from, and he said God told him that our sins are too much, we should repent. And you know, ordinarily, you expect the king to be so proud-hearted and say, to hell with it. The Bible says that even the king became pricked in the heart. The king removed his royal apparel. He put on sackcloth. He sat down on the floor and he declared fast to repent. That is how powerful the power of God moved, because Jonah did what God told him to do. One thing I've come to discover about God is that until you start doing what he asks you to do, even the power that he has made available for that thing will not come to pass. Until you embark on that project, until you render that help, until you go in that direction that God wants you to go, the power or the anointing, which is spiritual empowerment, that God has allotted to that instruction will not be released. Let me tell you this. Every time you have an instruction from God, maybe God wants to go in a particular way, he wants to help somebody, he wants to do something, there is always this anointing, supernatural empowerment that comes with it. If God says, marry this person and you marry that person, there's an anointing that will follow that marriage. If God says, help this person and you help that person, there's an anointing that will follow that, that will bless you. I want you to work for bless, don't work for a cause. Jonah lost everything. I am very sure that even all the things that he also packed, when the wave was blowing against the ship, they must have thrown it to the sea. He suffered loss, only that God didn't allow him to die. The scripture tells me that everything, let me read that scripture. The word reached the king of Nineveh, and he arose from his throne, removed his robe, covered himself with sackcloth, and sat in ashes. And he issued a proclamation throughout, published through all Nineveh, by the decree of the king and his noble. Let neither man nor beast, herd or flock, taste anything. Let them not feed or drink water, but let man and beast be covered with sackcloth, and let them call out mightily to God. Let everyone turn from his evil way and from the violence that is in their hands. Who knows? God may turn and relent and turn from his fierce anger, so that we may not perish. Verse 10. And when God saw what they did, how they turned from their evil ways, God relented of the disaster that he had said he would do to them, and God refused to do it. There are people that will be saved if only you can be obedient. There are lives, you know, we have a mission school back in Africa. I was being told by the administrator at a particular time that there is this woman that had two of our children in our school. Of course, some of them who came from outside paid, and then we have those that were admitted on scholarship. But because of hardship in Nigeria, this woman could not pay again, so she withdrew her children, took them to public school. Even the public school at the time, they stopped going. One day, I was told that that girl was passing in front of the school. She saw the administrator run to her and embrace her. And then the administrator said, why are you not in school? She said, I'm at home. You know, when we left this school, my mommy took us to another school, one school. And then from there, we went to public school. And now we are at home. The administrator said, she almost started weeping. She now said to her, do you still have your uniform? The girl said, yes, the uniform of this school, I have it. I keep it at home. Then the administrator told the lady, tell your mom to come and see, because I've given them instruction that we should be admitting people who cannot pay, but whose parents they don't have, but the children are eager to learn. Let's help them. When the mother came, she was told that the child should come back to school, no school fees, just buy books. The administrator said, the woman began to pray and pray and pray. She said, so that she will not curse. The woman began to pray and pray and pray. She was praying for me. She was praying for my family, praying for my children. Why? Because we gave her daughter scholarship until she finishes secondary school. And that, we're talking about basic 3 years. There's a particular man of God that I know also who died, and he had 4 children. And the wife was just a cleaner in a school. I told them, you know what? I was back in Nigeria then. I said, let your children come. Just buy a uniform. Let them be in the school. And then we put them on scholarship. The woman was praying and praying and praying. Now, do you know how much God will be happy with those that we... That is even among many people that we helped. It's not that we have all the money. As a matter of fact, sometimes I have to send them money to also offset certain bills back in Africa. But the truth is, I'm happy we are doing that because we are helping somebody. Because God puts it in my heart that I should be helping children. Is he part of what I desire that God will do for me, that I will build mentality? And then we're going to have pregnant women come for antenatal, and then they will deliver children. And if they need any drugs, we are trusting God. God will help us. We're giving them the medicine, and we'll take care of the children that are born on the 3 months. After then, they go to regular hospital. It's part of my vision. I've not done it, but I had the heart for it. What am I trying to say? Don't be like Jonah. Be like Jonah. Because whatsoever you make happen for others, God will make happen for you. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Let me quickly show you something. When we look at chapter 4 of the book of Jonah, after Jonah preached to those people and the whole land repented, they forsook their ways, and God averted the evil. You know the next thing? The man of God became angry. Let me read. But he displeased Jonah exceedingly, and he was angry. And he prayed to the Lord and said, "Oh Lord, is not this what I said when I was yet in my country? That is why I made haste to flee to Tarshish. For I knew that you are a gracious God and merciful, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love, and relenting from disaster. Therefore now, O Lord." Now, when you look at that scripture I just read now, he said, "Therefore now, O Lord, take my life, for it is better for me to die than to live." And the Lord said, Do you do well to be angry? You can't imagine. He's supposed to be angry, happy that, after all, at the end of the day, the people of Nineveh, a whole country, was saved. But this man was angry. That means he has selfish ambition. He has, you know, wrong motive in his mind. He's the kind of person who loves people to perish than to be saved. And you know, the truth is that you and I can be the same. We might be happy that evil things are happening to others. You don't say it out, but you're happy. They cannot eat. We that are working, that are making money, they don't know it's not easy. That kind of statement is a statement of pride. It shows that you are happy that these bad things are happening to them. That's what this prophet, I don't understand it. That's what he has in mind. He said, "God, didn't I tell you that you are a loving God? If I go to preach to them now, they will repent. And then you will not do this." Why will Jonah want the people to be destroyed? I don't understand. Why do you want evil to happen to people? People that work with you, your place of work, you are the one that's always report them to the management so that they can be sacked, so that they can be queried. What do you stand to gain? Don't you know whatsoever a man sow, that shall he reap? If you do evil to men, evil will come back to you. Jonah never wanted them to repent. And I don't understand why he would do that. And God said, "Jonah, really? You think you have the right to be angry? Are you sure you have the right to be angry? Because even he himself has been forgiven. He has been given another chance. And I wonder why he will not be happy that the people of Nineveh are given another chance. In life, we all make mistakes. Give people another chance. Help them to recover. If you have the passion to help those who are on drugs, who are alcoholic, who are prostitutes, help them to recover. Because we are all recipients of God's mercy. None of us is righteous by ourselves. It is Jesus that makes us righteous. Help other people." Let me show you something. When you look at verse 11, let me show you how many people that God used that mission work to save. Verse 11, God was still talking to Jonah. "And should I not pity Nineveh, that great city, in which There are more than 120,000 people who do not know their right from their left, and also much cattle. God said, Jonah, what is your problem? There are 120,000 people in that city that are just saved because you preached. You are supposed to rejoice that your mission was successful, and you are angry. You want them to be destroyed. What kind of man are you? And God said, we are counting human beings, not even counting the animals. And you know, the truth of life is that we all make mistakes. We are praying that God will use us to bless souls. Jonah was angry that people were repenting. What is the rationale of this story? Be careful. Watch your inner motive. Don't wish men evil. Don't wish them bad. Because whatever you wish others will come to you. Do good to people. Even if they have hurt you, forgive them. Do good to them. Give them another chance. Just like God gave Jonah another chance. And I believe as you do that, God will surprise you. In the name of Jesus. Let me go through some of the things I want you to know today. Now, before I finish this telecast, I want you to know that there's a special program that is coming up on Friday, June 8th. Friday, June 8th. It is an all-believers conference program. This program is for everyone that's a child of God. What I'll be teaching on doing on that day is to teach the word of God, and we are going to pray. And I believe as we pray together, the power of God will move, and yokes will be destroyed, the sick will be healed, the oppressed will be delivered, and the Lord Jesus will be glorified. It's a one-day program. It's coming up on Friday, 8th of June, 2018. And the theme of the program is overcoming satanic opposition to your glory. You have a great glory, but there are oppositions. Let's come together. Let's pray together. Under the anointing of the Holy Ghost, I believe that every opposition that has made sure that your glory will not manifest, they will be destroyed. That's the anointing God gave me. The Lord said to me, go, teach my people power. And he has made me to pass through so many things in life. And God has made me to have victory. And from the victory that God has given to me, I will teach you on how you too can have victory. And apart from that, we will pray together generally. And I'm going to minister specially to those who need special ministrations. And I believe God will do a great thing in your life as you come. Now, the program is going to take place at... let me get the address of the program for you. Now, the program is going to take place at Divine Heritage Hall, 9755 Kirkuk Road, Houston, Texas. 9755 South Kirkuk Road, Houston, Texas, 77099. That is the place where the program is going to take place. Make sure you mark your calendar Friday 8th. Tell your family members it will be a time of encounter in the presence of God. Before I go, let me just quickly tell you this. Any vision that God give back to never dies. Any vision that God give back to never dies. Even if it looks like nothing is going to happen, I can assure you something great is going to happen. Why? Any vision that God back never die. If you don't give up, that vision will come to pass. If you don't give up, you will see a glorious day. That's why after every darkness, there is always light of day. That's to tell you, your glory is going to shine. Time is going to celebrate you. And your generation will be happy that you were born. Now, I want you to bring your advert to this program so that, number one, you can help us to keep enlarging this program. Number two, your business can grow. Because as you bring your advert to this program, you are helping to provide funding for the program. And your own glory will also begin to enlarge because you are partnering with my glory. I know the glory of God that I carry. And I know nobody that supports me ever go bankrupt. And if you have been having problems in your business, use the anointing of God on my life as a point of contact. And there shall be a bounce back. God will surprise you in an immense, immense way. Now, time is not always on my side. I've got to go right now. But until I come here again next time, I want you to know that you have a glory and God has placed power within you. Don't give up because your beauty will show forth. God bless you. I'm Reverend Sam. Bye-bye.